Welcome Nation, a bit of very encouraging news from the most recent visa bulletin by the Department of State. The visa backlogs for employment-based visas from the Philippines is now very short. Here to tell us all about that is Attorney Eric Welsh from Reeves Law Immigration Group. Attorney, a bit of very good news.
It is. It's very good news indeed. So, yeah, visa backlogs, that's the amount of time that people have to wait for a visa, depending on their classification. That's depending on who petitions them to come to the United States.
Okay.
Sometimes that can be really, really long. Mm-hmm. The category we're talking about, employment-based, used to be 7, 8 years, even 10 years, not that long ago. And now the backlog is about a year, very short.
Very short. I mean, I think when you're saying from the time that you applied all the way to, you know, the point where you can get a green card, you're saying that can only just take up to a year.
That can be about a year.
Wow, that's a big change. Why is that, Attorney?
Well, the Department of State keeps track of who gets visas, and there's only a certain number of visas set by Congress. There's a quota. So once that's maxed out, people have to wait, sometimes very, very long. Mm-hmm. Some categories, it can be a 20-year backlog to get a visa. But right now, the Department of State is telling us that there are visas available. People are maybe not applying in the same degree that they had in years past, and so now that opens the door for people who do want to come and work in the country.
That's great. Okay, so let's find out more about what the kind of visa people may be eligible to apply for. That's the EB-3 visa, right? Tell us more about these employment-based visas.
Sure. So the EB-3 category is for skilled, unskilled, and professional workers. It's an extremely broad category. It's going to include nurses, caregivers, custodians, cooks. Almost every profession, it doesn't fit into one of the other employment-based categories, which are for smaller groups of workers. Mm-hmm. So EB-3 is our very, very broad cross-section of workers. And to get those visas, you have to have an employer. Mm-hmm. Employer's got to start a process with the Department of Labor to get a certification of a labor shortage, and then that employer's got to file a petition with the Immigration Service.
I see. Okay, and so once you get the wheels turning there, you know, it's just a short amount of time. Now, once the petition is filed and approved, then how does a worker get a green card?
So it depends on where they're at. If you're outside the country and a visa's available, you apply for it at the U.S. consulate.
Okay.
If the worker's in the United States and they're in lawful status, H-1B or student or some other lawful status, they can apply for the green card here through what's called adjustment of status.
Okay.
If they're out of status, then generally they can't apply unless they're eligible for an exception.
Okay. Now there are details to, you know, every person's story when it comes to maybe applying for these visas. What's the best piece of advice that you could give our viewers?
Well, absolutely, I say hire a lawyer. This is a complicated process, a lot of moving parts, a lot of very difficult barriers to overcome along the road. We're very encouraged by this short backlog, and we think it is something that if you have an employer who really likes you and wants to keep you and wants to do this process, it's something you should absolutely consider, but it's not going to be easy.
And you're saying that also because there can be, you know, exceptions, right? And what kind of exceptions maybe would allow a foreign worker to work to avail of the visa?
So if a person's not in status, if they're out of lawful status, they can do it if they've only been out of status for 180 days or less, that's 6 months or less.
Okay.
If it's more than that, then they might need either a waiver or some other relief. There's also something called grandfathering, which is if you have a petition that was filed for you before April 30, 2001, you might be eligible for an exception. If you have to apply outside the United States, that person may still be eligible for a waiver, a provisional waiver that would allow them to come back to the country instead of waiting outside the country for 10 years.
Okay, well, regardless of, you know, how complicated, you know, different cases may be, I think the important thing is there is a bit of encouraging news, and that encouraging news can be better supported with advice from a legal professional.
Absolutely, yeah. I think that anyone who's interested or encouraged should talk to a lawyer. They're going to need a lawyer, employer's going to need a lawyer. But they should get that process started now.
Okay, and let's make sure that we have the information available for our viewers. How do they get a hold of yourself and other legal professionals at Reeves?
Well, I appreciate that. Yeah, they can contact us at rreeves.com. We are Reeves Immigration Law Group. We have offices in Los Angeles, San Francisco, Las Vegas, and Manila.
All right. Well, great to have you, especially when you have some good news for us and for our viewers. Thank
Always
you.
Always happy to be here. Thank you.
Thank you, Attorney Welsh.